It's time for the Match Game, Hollywood Square. Our real Charles Nelson Reilly. But we've got it made. Ronnie Urseth. From Scarecrow and Mrs. King, Martha Smith. Larry Linville. McClane Stevenson. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Square's hour, Gene Raver and John Bowman.
Thank you all.
Doesn't seem right.
Here, welcome one and all. This is so far, I know it's only Wednesday, but it's been a terrific week so far. And I, if I don't get a chance to thank you at the end of the week, I thank you now for your kind, friendly, witty, charming participation. Charles!
And you are? We didn't get you. You are?
I'm Gene Rayburn.
How do you do?
How do you do? Nothing changes. I've known this guy for years. On the old series, he never wore socks, and he's still not wearing
no,
any
I
socks.
Forgot.
No socks! Charles, you gotta
I
wear socks.
I wore them. Check the tape. I wore them yesterday, but I took them home. I forgot.
Right. The but same I, ones. I, you'll probably wear them 2 weeks. Charles, a full-fledged professor is a man of dignity, yes. Should wear socks. Did you know he's a professor?
But I sit behind a desk, so they'll never know.
He's a professor in a non-profit making institution. Show him what it is, Charles.
Oh, come on, Charles, stand up.
It's the Burt Reynolds Institute for Theater Training.
Right. And the fact that it's non-profit means that he doesn't get paid.
No, the point of the matter is that one of our girls, Anne Morrison, is opening as we speak in London in the lead in a new musical, Peg.
One of your students?
Yes, of the Institute. And also she was the lead in Sondheim's musical on Broadway, Merrily We Roll Along. All our graduates are doing very well, and that's how you tell us if the school is good.
She owes her life and her career
no,
to you.
No,
you're wonderful,
she's
Charles.
She's going to get me 3 pair of Argyle socks from Piccadilly Circus.
All right, let's greet our two players here, Patty Olson and Pam Marks. Charles. Hello there.
Hi.
Now, let's get acquainted. Patty, let's hear about you.
Well, I'm a native Californian. I live in Westminster. I recently graduated from a business college, and I'm now working as a legal secretary. And in my spare time, I like to watch and participate in sports.
Good. Is it difficult being a legal secretary?
I'm just getting started, but it's going to be real difficult, I can tell.
All right. Good luck there, and here too, Patty.
Thank you.
Now, Pam, about you, please.
Well, I'm single. I just moved out to the Los Angeles area from Chicago in November, so I'm new out here. I'm a registered nurse, but I'm not practicing right now. I do sell legal pharmaceuticals to legal doctors, I hope, for a major pharmaceutical company in New Jersey.
So you are a registered nurse?
Yes, I am.
We have a very sick person over here.
Which one?
If I call on you in an emergency during the show, you will help out, won't you?
Oh, definitely.
Guy doesn't wear socks. A real sickie. Okay, let's go with the Match Game now. 3 chances to match as many of the stars as you can. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Patty, you won the toss. What do you want, A or B?
A, please.
A it is. This is numero uno. It says this. Did you hear that Horrible Hank is coming out with a horrible new breakfast cereal? Instead of Rice Krispies, it's called Blank Krispies.
Horrible Hank?
Horrible Hank, yes.
Horrible cereal.
Some dreadful thing. All right?
Yes.
Here we go, Patty. Did you hear the Horrible Hank is coming out with a horrible new breakfast cereal? Instead of Rice Krispies, it's called Blank Krispies.
Lice Krispies.
Lice Krispies, isn't that good? Very good, Patty. Okay, Bonnie.
That was such a good answer. I said Garbage Krispies.
Garbage Krispies? All right, McLean.
Yes, I too was going for the giggle instead of concentrating on the game.
Well,
I
that's
said,
all right.
Buffalo Chip Krispies.
Buffalo Chip Krispies. Ooh.
Don't boo that. That's quite amusing. Quite amusing.
Try to do better.
Right. I don't want to hurt his feelings. He doesn't come around very often. Hello, Larry.
Hello, Gene. This is the word I had to have help on. Lice Crispy.
Lice Crispy. Hey.
Lice!
Super Patty. Now, Martha.
For the sick members of our audience.
You've got to explain this answer.
I thought it was very horrible. You horrible draw. Human Crispy.
Human Crispy. You're right. All right. Nurse, I was wrong about the sick guy. It's a sick girl. Charles?
Close, but no cigar. Mice Crispy.
Mice Crispy is another good response. Mice and lice were two good ones. All right. Pamela.
Crispy.
Now, you've all seen the hit show about two husbands, two married detectives, about two married detectives called Heart to Heart. You're familiar with that show. Well, there's a new show about two married doctors. It's called Blank to Blank. Let me just give you a clarification here.
I got it.
Yeah, that's it. Okay.
Gee, that's great music, Gene. Who is that?
Barry Manilow.
Oh, Barry Manilow is it? That's wonderful. It sounded like Count Basie, but it is Barry Manilow.
It's not Barry Manilow. No. Ready, Martha?
Almost. Got a long word here.
All right. Pam. we're referring to the hit show about two married detectives called Heart to Heart, you know, Bob Wagner and all that. Now there's a new show about two married doctors, and it's called Blank to Blank.
Brain to Brain. Oh.
Your mother's applauding, but she's the only one. All right, Bonnie. Let's see what you've got.
I was going to say spleen, but I wasn't sure how to spell it, so I said liver to liver.
Liver to liver is good. That's the largest internal organ in the body.
I know that.
You did know that, Doctor.
I also know that when you copy your neighbor's answer...
It says liver to liver. No, I think liver to liver is quite good. Yes, don't you, Larry?
Yes, but McLean was more clever than I. At least he used bodily parts. I used... pill to pill.
Pill to pill. Two doctors, pill to pill. Aspirin to aspirin, something like that. That's not bad. All right.
Want to see my socks?
You wear them.
No, you like this answer, so I'm proud to repeat it.
Liver to liver is quite good. And Martha?
Keeping with my offbeat theme, bladder to bladder.
Bladder to bladder. Hang around, nurse.
I go with the crowd with another liver to liver.
Liver to liver. That does it. That really would have worked for you if you thought of it. All right, it's 2-0 to score at the end of round one. Round two for you right after this. We're all here to play Password.
6 decades of games.
May I have 60 seconds on the clock?
Thank you for being with us here on To Tell the Truth.
6 years on the air.
No kicking, no gouging, no punching.
Whoa.
Come celebrate Buzzer's 6th birthday.
Don't we look spiffy today?
Ta-da!
Welcome to Million Dollar Password.
With a game show marathon over half a century in the making.
Yell! Shout!
What is your name, please?
It's Buzzer's 6th birthday bash, June 5th, only on Buzzer.
Ladies, what's the free at SmileDirectClub.com?
Here we go. Round two coming up.
A little gooder on this
now, one. Before we actually begin the round, I just want to remind you once again that we're going to do another one of those fascinating telephone contests in which somebody out there might win $5,000 and a chance to appear on an NBC soap opera. So tune in next week for the rules, okay? And speaking of next week, sitting up there, we are going to have all NBC soap opera stars. So, you soap opera fans, be sure to tune in. You're going to meet them here in an informal setting, and you'll see them in a way you've never seen them on the big NBC hit soap operas, or daytime dramas, as they like to call them. Now we go to round two here. Patty, you're ahead. You go first.
I'll stick with A, please.
All right. Four people play. John and Larry lay out. Here it is. Tex said, I reckon that new cow girl never worked on a ranch before. She's got her spurs strapped onto her blank.
The
Do you understand?
No. I mean, it was a marvelous dialect. I love this. It's perfectly cowgirl.
Logical. It's a good answer.
I can't do Texas too good. You do Texas, Larry?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, sure.
Well, we'll read a Texas style.
Tex said, I reckon that new cowgirl never worked on a ranch before. She got her spurs strapped onto her blank.
Okay. I saw Jack Klugman do his Texas the other night. He slips in and out of it occasionally.
Does he really?
Yes. But it's an interesting play. All right, Patty. Tex said, I reckon that new cowgirl never worked on a ranch before. She's got her spurs strapped onto her blank.
Waist?
Waist? You think the loonies are going to say waist, eh, Patty?
No.
All right, Bonnie.
And to her bottom.
To her bottom. See? Did you copy again?
No.
No.
She wrote too fast and went like
all right.
I don't know where my mind is. I said bra. Does that make
sure
sense?
Bra?
It's okay.
Now, wait a minute.
I would've said that.
Hold everything. There's a lot of logic there.
Sure.
Somebody makes a pass at her, he cuts his hand. Right? I think that's a good idea. What do you say? No, you don't say anything.
I don't say anything. No.
You say something.
I say she's got her spurs strapped on her elbows.
To her elbows. All right. What came to your mind, Chuck?
Boobs.
Okay.
Turn to pain, that's what it is.
I know what it is.
Everything but waste, Patty. Now, Pam, let's see how you do. Ethel said, the way to the average man's heart is through his stomach. But not my husband, the plumber. The way to a plumber's heart is through his blank.
Oh, it comes to mind, Gino. It comes to mind.
All right. I love your dignified three-piece ensemble.
Isn't that lovely?
Yes, lovely.
I was married in that.
You were?
Yes, and I'm going to be buried in it.
He's a one-suit man. I guess we're all ready. Here we go, Pam. Ethel said the way to the average man's heart is through his stomach, but not my husband, the plumber. The way to a plumber's heart is through his blank.
Pipes.
Through his pipes. Plumbers work with pipes and copper tubing and all that material. What do you say, Bonnie?
Pipes.
Pipes, it is. 2-1 the score.
Well, she's going too fast. First I said snake, and then I said plunger.
Snake or plunger. Two good responses. Plumbers work with those things.
Oh,
I don't understand
that was
them.
Good.
Larry?
Well, this is kind of approximately like Bonnie's. I don't know if this is close enough. I said through his plumbing.
Through his plumbing. Well, they very quickly responded in the negative there.
No.
No. Pipes is Pam's answer, John. What do you say?
I'm going just the same speed as McLean. I think this is definitive. This plunger.
Plunger.
Take my plunger, please.
All right. Martha?
I said pipes.
Okay. Two for Pam. Tie game. Tight game going here, Chuck.
I tell you.
Kidney.
There's one in every crowd.
Think about it.
Nurse, I changed my mind. There are two patients over here. All right, 2-2 the score at the end of round two. A tight, close game here. Tune in and see how it turns out right after this.
Expensive dental procedures?
All health markets now.
Okay, the third and final round coming up right now. Now, since the score is tied, and Patty went first last time, Pam will ask you to go first this time.
Well, let's take A.
You want to take A?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Four people play. You know who you are. Linda said, I think my obstetrician used to be a basketball player. After my baby was born, the doctor blanked him.
I know this one.
Now, since you don't play this round, if you do have a good answer, oh, well, he's already written. I thought you might offer a little. Oh, you ready, Larry?
Yes.
All right. Pam, Linda said, I think my obstetrician used to be a basketball player. After my baby was born, the doctor blanked him.
Bounced.
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 Right. Oh, good. All right. Hold everything. May I get a ruling from the judge in advance? Will bounced and dribble match?
Yes.
They will, okay?
She's going
just
to
in case somebody says dribbled over here. McLean? Bounced and dribble do match because it's the same action.
Oh, boy, world without end. I said slam dunked.
I think it's wonderful. Terrific. Slam dunk.
Booing out there.
What are you laughing at?
I left out the slam.
Just dunk. That's okay. Now, what do you got for us, John?
I've been known to dribble right here on this show, so how could I resist the perfect answer? Dribble.
All right. One to Sam. She's up to three. Chuck.
Dribble.
Another one. So you've got four all together, and Patty, that means you need two to tie and three to win. Here we go. The people in Beverly Hills are really ritzy.
How ritzy are they?
How ritzy are they?
That timing, show business. Great.
It's my life.
I'll tell you how ritzy they are. When they perspire, blank comes out of their pores.
I know.
That's how ritzy they are. That's one possibility. That's another one.
Wait.
Yeah, very good.
Which one do you like better? Instinct. Say that for a second.
Ra-pa-pa-pa-pa-dum. Ra-pa-pa-pa-pa-dum. Here we go. Ready, Patty?
Ready.
Now, here it is. The Beverly, people in Beverly Hills are so ritzy, when they perspire, blank comes out of their pores.
Champagne.
Champagne. I like that.
World's worst speller.
Champagne. What are you laughing at, Bunny?
He's laughing at my spelling.
Spelling doesn't count. If we can figure it out and by
this
some...
one's right. That's why I changed my answer. Champagne.
Champagne. All right, we need another bottle of champagne to get a tie score.
You got it.
Tie score. Martha.
Yes.
One more bottle of champagne and Patty will be the winner.
Fine, I'll have some. Moet Chandon is fine. Thank you.
Oh, all right.
No, I was thinking the Beverly Hillbillies. I was talking about oil comes out of their pores.
Oil. Have we got a tie or a win?
Well, we got either, right? We have a tie because I said Perrier.
Perrier is a good answer, so we do have a tie. And we'll go right to the tiebreaker. Okay, here we go. Tiebreaker question reads as follows. Land blank. Land as L-A-N-D blank. Now, here in front of you, but out of sight of the stars, are four pretty good answers to that question. Your seats were determined by lot, so Pam, you'll go first. I'll ask you to choose a response here by number only. Don't say any words. Tell me if you want one, two, three, or four.
One.
You want one. You've got one. Now, Patty, you tell me by number what answer you'd like to have.
Four, please.
You want number four. Now, I'm going to go over here and talk to the stars and canvass them and get verbal responses from them. And as soon as you hear your answer, let me know in some demonstrable way, whatever that means. Hello, Bonnie. Land blank.
Landmark.
Landmark. Does anybody have that? No. What do you say, McLean?
I'll tell you what I say, Gene.
What?
Land locked.
Land locked. Nobody has that. What do you say?
I've got landlord.
Landlord, yeah! Who has that? Pam the nurse has landlord. Come on down, Pam. Right there on the spot. Patty, what a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Going to send some gifts to you from the match game. Patty Olson, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. How do you feel?
Wonderful.
Good. We congratulate you. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. Bring on three more celebrities. Here comes the rest of the set. Lots more going on here. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's 25-inch color console TV. Features random access, 125-channel remote system, LED channel readout, light sensor, and automatic color system furnished by Montgomery Ward. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, our with Nidra Bowles. From Night Court, Richard Mall. From the hotel, Nathan Cook. taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
And we'll be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a minute. Be there.
When you're feeling hot,
1717 now.
And now, John Bowman at the Hollywood Squares.
Pam Marks, you're one of the very few people who has something good to say about her landlord.
Oh, yeah, especially now.
Right. Landlord helped you get into the Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities to join you. Nedra Voles, Richard Mall, and Nathan Cook. Nathan, anything upcoming that's new in your life?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I've been very busy. So busy, in fact, that I'm going to be a father in September.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, I was born in September. You willing to name this kid after me?
Maybe November, then. No.
Thank you. In answer to the question, what's cooking? Nathan had a good one. And Pam Marks lets you and I cook right over here and play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. We have the returning champion, your opponent. His name is Scott Johnstone. We must reacquaint ourselves with him and reacquaint ourselves with his total. $23,250. Have those numbers kind of been rolling around in your head overnight,
Scott? Overnight, they sure have.
Why don't you just remind us a little bit about your life to date?
Well, I live in Newport Beach, and I missed my party because of the show. That's okay. I'll throw a bigger one in a couple of weeks. So
there'll be many more. That's and
John
you're
and
not
I are coming to that, aren't we, John?
Yes,
yeah,
right.
Sure we are. And I believe the studio audience is invited, and everyone at home.
Okay.
That's what you said, Scott Johnstone. We're going to hold you to it.
You bet.
So when you call in for that telephone match next week, we'll be giving you Scott's address as well. For the moment, we're just going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell, and whoever is ahead at that point also gets to go to Scott's party and may go on to play Supermatch, will go on to play Supermatch, may play it for $30,000. First game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Scott Johnstone, you're the champ. Start us off.
McLean, please.
McLean Stevenson. Was Playboy the first American magazine to publish pictures of naked bosoms? Or was there another national magazine that did that first?
Easy for you, McLean.
No. I go back to when Collier's was a nickel. I think I saw my first set in... long before Playboy. I think it was in a Sears Roebuck catalog. Yeah, huh? Whiz Bang. That's right, Whiz Bang.
So he says there was another magazine that did that first. Agree or disagree, Scott?
I'll agree.
There was another magazine that published that first. You were right to agree, and you get the first square. However, the answer may surprise some. It's a bit of a tricky question. National Geographic. Published photos of naked natives in the early 1900s. Pam, your move.
Gene Place.
Gene Rayburn.
All right, Pam.
For an O.
Okay.
You're having a formal dinner party, Gene.
Yes.
According to Amy Vanderbilt's Everyday Etiquette, is it okay to turn on the Dukes of Hazzard after dinner? Or is that terribly tacky?
Well, based on some of the previous things that have gone on here with Amy Vanderbilt, I don't agree with all of her rules and regulations. I think she's a little far out on some of them.
Thank you, Senator. Go ahead.
Right.
Get it off your chest.
I don't know.
By the way, the issue here is it okay to turn on TV after dinner? It's not just the Dukes of Hazzard. You
right.
know what I mean?
Nothing personal, Dukes of Hazzard. I would say that... I would say that at a dinner party, it would not be the correct thing to do. You know, the men retire to the drawing room with their cigars, and the women go do their needlepoint or whatever.
He says TV's a no-no after a formal dinner party. What do you say, Pam?
Amy Vanderbilt.
I agree.
It is tacky after a formal dinner party. According to Amy Vanderbilt, you're right, you're right, and you get the square. Whether it's Dukes or Hazzard or Masterpiece Theater, Amy says don't do it. Scott, your move.
Charles, please.
Charles Nelson Reilly. What's longer, Charles? A round in a professional boxing match or the average nosebleed?
The doctor can't help you.
I would go with the average nosebleed. The longer I think is the boxing round. Because usually I coagulated very fast. But that mightn't be average.
Charles says a round in a professional boxing match is longer than the average nosebleed. What do you say, Scott?
I'll agree.
The nosebleed is longer. No, you should have disagreed with Charles, who maybe should have gone with his first instinct. Your opponent gets that square, and there's quite a big difference. A nosebleed on the average lasts about 10 minutes. Professional boxing round, I think, is 3 minutes long. These commercials are going to be about 2 minutes long, and then we'll see you and complete this $100 game.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
No more.
Clean up on aisle four.
Now, it's just shopping.
Are you ready to go shopping?
Join the shopping spree on Supermarket Sweep, weeknights at 9, right here on Buzzer. Let's play.
I'm always on the go.
It's today. Fiverr.
Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
50 for the challenger, 25 for the champ. Will he be going to the party sooner than he thinks? Plenty of time yet today. Pam, it is your move, however.
Let's go with Martha to win.
Right. This could win you the first here. Martha Smith.
Yes.
If a girl with oily skin spreads crushed tomato pulp on her face, will this help her complexion? Or will it only make people think she's kinky?
I'm an expert on kink. I can tell you a lot about this. Crushed tomato. Excuse me, the church group. I forgot. Just kidding. Tomatoes. I know a lot about tomatoes. And it's really not good if she has oily skin because the acid will increase her prone toward acne vulgaris. And I think it also is a little kinky, so I will say kinky.
Okay. Won't help her complexion. Agree or disagree, Pam, for the game, that crushed tomato pulp will not help your complexion?
I'll agree.
If a girl with oily skin spreads crushed tomato pulp on her face, it will help her complexion, apparently.
Oh.
I know. It shocks me. All right. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you there. That was a pivot point in the game. Scott, can you take advantage?
Sure. Richard, to win.
Now? No. Okay.
This is it. Richard Mall.
Go for it.
Night court for you.
Yeah.
According to How to Dress Your Man, is it okay for a man to
watch it? Easy does it now. Hey, I didn't even know you knew about that.
Is it okay for a man to wear high-heeled cowboy boots every day? Or should he only wear high heels every other day?
When I wear my high heels, I get such lumps on my head, kind of go through a door, you wouldn't believe it. Every other day? Mm-hmm. I think that you need a little variety to spice it up. I would say, hey, every other day, and usually with pearls and a black cocktail dress.
He says, you should only wear high-heeled cowboy boots every other day.
I'll agree.
Agree or disagree?
I'll
you
agree.
Will agree. You should alternate your high heels. You are perfectly right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. Well done. You doped that one out. So did Richard. The verdict has come in. You both played very well. And Scott, you are in the lead. It is only Cowboy George who wears them every day. You have $175.50 for your opponent, but we will sweep the X's and O's off of the board and begin a $200 game with you, Pam.
Let's go with Gene.
Gene Rayburn.
All right.
Oh.
Gene, will your goose make a good watchdog? Or is he next to worthless?
Oh, no. Geese can be hostile, and they can make rather loud noises with their beaks if strangers approach. So they're not totally worthless, and they're delicious.
Agree or disagree, Pam? He says geese make good watchdogs.
I agree.
Geese are good watchdogs.
Yeah.
And
nice.
So watch geese.
And then German Shepherds.
That's right.
Bumper sticker. Honk if you see my stereo being lifted. Scott, your move.
McLean.
Okay, McLean for an X. She went away from the center square. You may capture it. Most women who did it do it most women who do it.
start over.
Most women who do it when they're in their early 50s.
Uh-huh.
Is that the age most women have their faces lifted? Or is that the age they move to Florida?
Or, do you know how many women are going to be running around the house with tomatoes on their face tonight?
Well, will they be on their lifted faces or on their faces in Florida?
Most women after 50, what was the thing other than Florida? I'm sorry.
They either have their faces lifted in their early 50s or they move to Florida.
No, they have their faces lifted.
Okay.
I read that in Medical Digest.
What do you say, Scott?
Magazine.
Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
That is the average age for a facelift. You are perfectly right to agree, and you get the square. That gives us an X and an O in a $200 game. Everything hangs in the balance. We will find out what happens after this.
Concentrate.
At SmileDirectClub.com.
200 for the champ, 75 for the challenger, but really it's a tight game because the $200 that wins this one could swing the balance. Pam Marks, your move.
Let's go with Nidra, please.
Okay.
Oh, I was about to take a nap.
Nidra Vols, you've just made love.
I did?
Not again, Nidra.
Then that wasn't a dream.
You've just made love, and your boyfriend hops out of bed and makes a salami sandwich. Turning into a nightmare, isn't it?
I can hardly wait.
Now, according to Cosmo's Guide to Marvelous Men, Nidra, is this typical? Or are you out with a weirdo?
Well, they usually have pastrami on rye. let's face it, he's a weirdo. Yeah.
Agree or disagree that if that guy hops right out of bed and makes a salami sandwich, he's a weirdo, Pam?
Can I clarify, can it be any kind of sandwich? Is that be salami?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm going to disagree.
You're going to disagree?
Yeah.
Have you read Cosmo's Guide to Marvelous Men? Because according to them, it is typical for him to hop out of bed and make a sandwich. You're right to disagree, and you get the square.
Get ready for the next one.
Very well done. Boy, that could have fooled me.
Having a cigarette.
I guess there must be something wrong with me. I don't know. Scott, I've never done that. Scott Johnstone, your move.
Bonnie the Block.
Okay. You missed this one. The game and the lead goes over to your opponent. Bonnie Urseth, you went to Europe for a month, and you left Leicester, your pet African lungfish, with plenty of food, but without any water in his tank.
Oh, me. Poor Lester. Okay.
Now, when you return, will Lester be happy to see you? Or will he be dead?
I'm happy to see you.
My African lungfish.
Right.
Well, this has got to be a trick answer. I think he's going to be happy to see me. I think it's a trick. They're trying to make me think that he'd be dead, but I think he doesn't need water.
Gotcha. Agree or disagree, Scott? She says, happy to see you.
I disagree.
Lester the lungfish, after that month, will be happy to see you. Bonnie doped out that question. You should have agreed with her. You're caught against the square, and he wins the second game. Well, you hit the lungfish right on the head. A lungfish apparently can go without water for quite a long time, and the lead has gone over to Pam Marks, but it's still a very tight game. Sweep the O's and the solitary X off of the board, and Scott, you get to start a $300 game. Everything hangs on this.
McLean
Stevenson. Can stress really make your hair fall out? Or do you have nothing to worry about?
I mean, you're making this a personal... No, stress... can make your hair fall out and your tummy shout howdy.
Agree or disagree, Scott?
I'll agree.
Just with the stress part. That's, yeah. Stress can make your hair fall out. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Well done. You can relax now, McLean. Pam, your move for an O.
Well, let's go with Gene.
Let's go with Gene.
Okay, Mr.
Let's
Rayburn.
Go with Gene.
What's worth more money, Gene? Gerald Ford's autograph or a 20-pound sack of manure?
Nothing personal, Jerry.
See a difference.
What's a 20-pound sack of manure worth?
1985.
I'd say the manure is worth more because he's still alive and he signs a lot of them. There must be thousands and thousands of them around, so the manure would probably be more valuable than one of his autographs.
What do you say, Pam? Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Isn't that logical?
The autograph is worth more. You
what?
Should have disagreed with Gene. No. Should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square. Gerald Ford's autograph is worth $50. Okay, Scott, that's a big,
I wouldn't
big,
give
big,
you a nickel.
Big break for you. Let's keep it going and pick a star.
Nathan to win.
Okay, Nathan Cook would give you this game. Mr. Yes. Cook, should you rub your girlfriend's frostbite?
Definitely. Oh, there's more.
Or should you keep your hands to yourself?
No, you should rub your girlfriend's frostbite. Even if you don't have, she doesn't have frostbite, you should rub it, but yeah.
Agree or disagree, Scott?
He says
you should. You should keep your hands to yourself. You should have disagreed with Nathan, and your opponent gets that square. Don't rub frostbite is the moral of the story. Big break for you. Pick a star.
Don't eat salami afterwards.
Pick a star, Pam.
Let's go with Charles.
Okay.
Warm salami.
Charles Nelson Reilly, do they grow bananas in Iceland? Or do you stand a snowball's chance in heck of finding them there?
Oh, it's worse than the koala bear of 2 days ago. I would say that it's a tropical situation and you wouldn't find them any place up there where there's so many ice cubes.
Agree or disagree that there are no bananas in Iceland? They don't grow them there.
I'll disagree.
They grow bananas in Iceland. Ooh. You have done it. You're right to disagree, and you get that square. Wow. And the bell means that time is up. She has unseated our defending champ, $375 for Pam Marks. Atta girl. Wow.
I'm going to my party.
She has made her way over to Gene Rayburn. Get ready, get herself set for the shot at the big money. And Scott.
Now I'm going to my party. I can make it.
You're just in time for your party now,
I know,
Scott.
Yes, I swear.
Everyone can come. The church group's invited.
Maybe.
You played brilliantly at least 2 days, and really you didn't play too badly today either. This game could have gone either way. Your total leaving here, $23,500. Attaboy, Scott Johnstone. Gene, take it away.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ. We'll be back with her and the stars for a goal at the Big Dole right after this.
Next on Classic Concentration, one picture could be worth $1,000. And are you concentrating? Good. Another Classic Concentration is on after that. Stay tuned.
When knee pain stops for fit.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gino. Well, here we are. We have a new champ, and we wish her well. You could win up to $30,000 here in the Super Match. Ready?
Yeah.
Shall we begin?
Yeah.
Okay. I ain't going to start without you. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank ache. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, it's $1,000. Second most popular, $500. Third, $250. Whom do you call on for a little assist here?
John.
I'm going to say the thing that this question is giving me, which is a headache.
All right, you've got one now.
There's a bunch of good ones.
Larry?
Larry, she called on you.
Backache.
Backache.
Charles?
Heartache.
Heartache. From the song of the same name. So now you have heartache, backache, and headache. And it's time for you to choose one of those, or perhaps think up one of your own if you don't like any of those.
I'm going to go with headache.
Headache is the one that John gave you. Let's see if it's up there. And if it's up in the top spot, that's the important thing. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal a $250 response. Toothache is there. That's a good one. A common one. The $500 response says, backache. All right, you were given that by Larry. And it looks pretty good to me that headache is going to be on top. So let's find out right now. Slide it, Steve. All right, you've got it. $1,000. Now you got $1,375 altogether.
Another woman with a headache.
Right. All right. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision which star you want to play with, we'll ask that person to reveal the hidden number and find out what the multiplying factor is for your $1,000, whether it's going to be 10, 20, or 130 up there somewhere. Can you find it?
Let's go with Bonnie. Oh,
Bonnie, nice. She thinks you may be have the big 3-0.
Okay.
Would you take the tab and give it a yank? $20,000 is what you're playing for. $20,000. Good luck, Pam. Now you face me. Here it is, Bonnie. Ready? No help from the audience, please, because if we hear an answer, we're going to have to throw it out. Roy Blank. Roy Blank. Bonnie's ready. Pam, I see you're smiling. Does that mean you have an answer?
Oh, I hope it's Roy Rogers.
You hope it's Roy Rogers? They think it's Roy Rogers. Bonnie, from the reaction of the audience, if you don't say Roy Rogers, they're going to run up on this stage and beat you about the head and shoulders with their sticks.
Roy Rogers.
Happy Trails, his theme song. Listen, this lady is very happy. She has $21,375. We'll be back with her and the stars right after this.
Does getting into your parked car
save?
As long as you can say Rogers.
All right.
You're okay. That's all you have to do.
Pam has been watching the match game for a long time, and she's very happy at this moment. She still can't believe it. She does indeed have a bundle of money. Now we want to find out which of the stars had the big number.
Ooh, let's
130
check.
Up there somewhere. Ready, set, go. Nidra had the big 3-0. Thank you, stars. You were terrific.
As always.
Pam, we'll see you tomorrow. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babin saying so long for the Match Game, Hollywood's Grant Harris. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Whirlpool's portable, convertible, or undercounter dishwasher with DuraFirm door, super scour cycle, and exclusive in-the-door silverware basket furnished by Whirlpool. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Square Tower. A Mark Goodson Television Productions.